and relating to the final outer limits. The main body, which shows geomorphology of the area, demonstration of natural prolongation, in other words, you must show that you are entitled to this. Description and analysis of the data that you collect, and foot of the slope selection, or you selected the foot of the slope. Then, in the main body again, you show the selection of the outer limits and any references. The supporting documents, charts, coordinates, and any other supporting information that you might have to support your claim. And it is very important that you have this supporting information, because you should remember that the commission is looking at your claim, and it has to go by whatever you present. The submission is presented to the UN Secretary General, and then due publicity is given in accordance with UN rules. The CLCS will then convene a meeting to examine the submission. And of course, the submission is presented by the coastal state representative. The CLCS will then nominate the members of the subcommission who will examine the submission, and arrangements will be made with the Division of Ocean and Law of the Sea for the meetings for the examination of the submission. The subcommission will then make a preliminary assessment of the submission to ascertain that the format complies with that specified by the commission. If there is a need for any clarification by the submitting coastal state, and they would either do this in writing, or they will call back, or the state representative may come back to clarify anything that they require. If there are relevant disputes to be considered, if there is a need for a specialist advice, whether from within the commission or external, sometimes the subcommission might not have all the relevant technical expert to this particular submission. So they can always seek advice from within the commission, from other members of the commission, or possible from external sources. The subcommission will then report back to the commission on requirements and estimated time to examine the submission. The subcommission will consider all the relevant data submitted. It will then arrive at a final decision, and then it reports back to the commission. Now, collecting this data is a very expensive and time-consuming effort, the actual data that you use for your submission. It involves technical personnel, ship, crew, equipment, and it costs a lot of money. I'm trying to find, I did an estimate of the cost. Of course, the cost is dependent on where the data is to be collected and what type of data is to be collected, whether it be multi-beam or gravity magnetics and seismic data. And of course, the more technical you get, you know, if you're just collecting multi-beam data, then that would probably be a little bit cheaper. But the more you get into the magnetics and the seismic work, then it means that you have more equipment on board your vessel. So therefore, you have more cost. And I think you are probably looking, for a multi-beam, you're probably looking at probably $60,000 US per day. And for the rest, you're probably, to outfitting a ship, you're probably looking at $100,000, pretty close to $100,000 per day. And that would not include the mobilization and demobilization of the vessel, because all of this will depend on how far you have to go. What are the potential benefits? There is a potential for hydrocarbons, fisheries, minerals, and how do you recover? How do you recover this money that you're spending? Mark, you will always have this area, right? But in the short term or medium term, I think you can recover by dividing the area that you got into blocks and then probably sell them off to the oil companies for exploration. Thank you very much. Some acknowledgments there, and thank you very much. Mr. Chairman, is yes. That they understood everything that I was saying, or I was talking foolishly? There is a deadline.
Institutions created by the convention. I think that during the course of my presentation, or my statement, perhaps you will see why that's the best place that I could have found to give the statement of my division. The Division for Ocean Affairs and the Law of the Sea, Office of Legal Affairs of the United Nations, serves as the Secretariat of the United Nations Convention for the Law of the Sea. The agreement relating to the implementation of Part 11 of the Convention and the agreement for the implementation of the provisions of the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea relating to the conservation and management of threatened fish stocks and highly migratory fish stocks. The Division discharges the responsibilities entrusted to the Secretary General by the convention and the implementing agreements, as well as the mandates provided to it in its resolutions of the General Assembly in the field of oceans and the law of the sea. The division prepares several reports annually on oceans and the law of the sea, and services an increasing number of intergovernmental meetings, conferences, and workshops, in addition to the consultations preceding the adoption of the annual report of the annual General Assembly resolutions on oceans and the law of the sea and on sustainable fisheries. In all its work, the division cooperates with other international organizations and bodies dealing with oceans issues. The division contributes to the effective functioning of the convention system of institutions and bodies by providing substantive and procedural servicing to the meetings of states parties to the convention and to the Commission on the Limits of the Continental Shelf, and by participating in the implementation of the two relationship agreements between the United Nations and the International Seabed Authority and between the United Nations and the International Tribunal for the Law of the Sea, as well as by liaising with these two institutions. The division also services the informal consultations of states parties to the United Nations Fish Stocks Agreement, which is the mechanism established by the General Assembly to monitor the implementation of that agreement. The states parties meet annually in order to consider, among other things, implementation of the Fish Stocks Agreement at the global, regional, and sub-regional levels. In its role as the global institution having the competence to undertake an annual review and evaluation of the implementation of the Convention and other developments relating to ocean affairs and the law of the sea, the General Assembly is substantively assisted by the division. The reports of the Secretary General on oceans and the law of the sea and on sustainable fisheries, as well as the special reports and studies, constitute the basis for the consideration and review by the General Assembly of such developments. The division also assists member states in their consultations on the draft resolutions on oceans and the law of the sea and on sustainable fisheries. Furthermore, the Division Services, United Nations open-ended informal consultative process on oceans and the law of the sea, established by the General Assembly to facilitate the annual review in an effective and constructive manner of developments in ocean affairs and the law of the sea, with emphasis on identifying issues where international coordination and cooperation should be enhanced. Moreover, the Division Services, the ad hoc open-ended informal working group to study issues relating to the conservation and sustainable use of marine biological diversity beyond areas of national jurisdiction established by the General Assembly pursuant to Resolution 59/24. The division also provides secretariat support to the regular process for global reporting and assessment of the state of the marine environment, including socioeconomic aspects, and to its established institutions, such as the Group of Experts, pursuant to Resolution 65/37 and 65/37B. The division further provides a wide range of services to states and intergovernmental organizations, including provision of information, advice, and assistance with a view to promoting better understanding of the Convention and the UN Fish Stocks Agreement, their wider acceptance, uniform and consistent application, and effective implementation. The division also assists member states in their efforts to derive practical benefits from the international legal regime for the oceans as provided in these legal instruments. In this area, emphasis is given to developing and building up capacities of states, including human resources, institutional infrastructures, as well as legal and technical resources. As the focal point in the United Nations system for ocean affairs and the law of the sea, the division monitors closely the work of and cooperates with competent United Nations agencies, international organizations and entities at the sub-regional, regional, and global levels, in particular, the International Maritime Organization, the Food and Agriculture Organization, the Intergovernmental Oceanographic Commission of UNESCO, the United Nations Environment Program, the Secretariat of the Convention on Biological Diversity, and regional fisheries bodies. This is to ensure that the legal framework contained in the Convention and its implementing agreements is uniformly implemented and to avoid duplication of efforts and overlaps among competent organizations and bodies. The division attends the meetings of these organizations and bodies and collaborates with a number of them in the preparation of parliamentary documentation or studies. It also contributes to the work of UN Oceans and its task forces. The division's capacity building activities include the Hamilton Shirley Amerisinghe Memorial Fellowship on the Law of the Sea and the UN Nippon Foundation Fellowship Program. The division also manages several trust funds. One of the areas of DOALOS's functions that is of direct relevance to the work of the International Seabed Authority is the work of the Commission on the Limits of the Continental Shelf. As you are all aware, the work of the Commission attempts to bring precision to the limits of the national and international jurisdictions. The Commission has before it a large number of submissions, 55 to be exact, and several more yet to come. In view of the large number of submissions, the 20th meeting of states parties to UNCLOS, held in June 2010, considered again the issue of the workload of the Commission, making a number of recommendations to the Commission. The meeting also decided to continue to address the issue through an informal working group, which is expected to make recommendations to the next meeting in June 2011. In addition, the current term of office of the members of the Commission expires in June 2012. The election of members of the Commission by the meeting of states parties in June 2012 will mark the beginning of a new period, since the Commission will be expected to make significant progress in the consideration of submissions and issuance of recommendations. At its 27th session in March-April 2011, the Commission has before it for adoption three additional recommendations prepared by their respective subcommissions in relation to the submission by Indonesia, in respect to northwest of Sumatra Island, the joint submission by Mauritius and Seychelles in the regions of the Mascarene Plateau, and the submission by Suriname. At its 26th session in August-September 2010, the Commission had adopted a total of 11 recommendations.